episode 28 of the Director of Football Journeyman with Gent. I'm going to say this every time we start a new episode. For how long? Today we have the Champions League group stage draw. We are in the top seeds, which is fantastic. So we can get a very interesting group based purely on the fact that we're a top seed. There's a lot of teams in group in the second seeds. I don't really want to play any of them. Although we've proven we can beat Chelsea. So groups, the third seeds, not terrible. We can't get Bruges. And who's in the fourth seeds? We have nobody too scary. So we're going to draw. Okay, so we're group B. Alright, so Zenit get Atletico. I think because Barcelona are group C, we can't get Real Madrid. Valencia. Okay, so that proves me completely wrong. We could get a Spanish team. So for third seed, all right, we can't get Salzburg. Who do we want? Can't get Bruges. So I'm going to say we're probably going to get Napoli, but I'd like Olympiacos. Arsenal. Okay. Who do? Okay, so Olympiacos get Bayern Munich and Inter Milan. Fair enough. Right, no Belgian teams in this pot, so we are going to say it's probably going to be Monaco, but I would like Nice. Not going to get Nice. AZ, Sparta Prague. Okay, fair enough. So we'll have a quick look before I click the last one. Group H, horrible looking. Group A, Atletico Madrid are going to walk that group. Zenit and Nice, maybe. The fight for second is going to be interesting in that group. We don't have an easy group. We did beat Valencia last year, but they've bought a couple of. They bought one of our better players in the summer. Arsenal, that's scary. Sparta Prague, they should be the whipping boys. Group C, I think you can say there's really two teams that are pretty much guaranteed to go through there. Krasnodar and Vitória de Guimarães could cause an upset. Group D, that's a horror show. It's Chelsea, Real Madrid, Napoli, Basel. Group D looks difficult. Group E is Benfica, Man City, Leon and Fenerbahce. That's a group that will be, I'm going to keep my eye on. That looks interesting. As does Group F, Juventus, Liverpool, Borussia Dortmund, AZ. Three very, very good teams, and then AZ. Unfortunate for them. Group G, Paris Saint-Germain, Porto, Club Brugge, and Celtic. Oh, Club Brugge are screwed. I don't think they're going to get out of that group. I don't think they're going to get third. I'd be surprised if they get third. They've had a poor start to the season. I'm going to say fourth. And then Group H is Bayern Munich, Inter Milan, Olympiacos, Monaco. I wouldn't expect them to do all that well. So, as you can see, the games we've played since you were here last, we beat Sintroense 3-1. Jack Clark scored a brace, and Carlos Roberto scored a cheeky little goal. And then against Charleroi, 5-2. I want to show you one of the goals, though, because when I saw this goal was tasty. Now, I may be misremembering, but it was, hopefully it shows. Okay, it's not going to show the way I wanted to, so we're going to have to change to behind goal so you can see it properly. Look at that. Okay, we're going to have to play it again. But we're going to slow it down a small bit because it's a little quick. So watch Roberto. Look at that. Oh, back heeled it in. Midair. Oh. Bellissimo. Bellissimo. Right, so that is everything I wanted to show you. We will click forward one and see who we get, or yeah, who's the first two teams, the first team, what way the, okay, we know we're handed a tough group, who do we play first? We play Valencia first. So I think we'll come back for the Valencia game in just a second. I don't think we're going to put another game in because it might take too long in game then. We'll have a look and see how long the Valencia game takes, because we're already 5 minutes into this. Don't want it to go on all that long. So Valencia definitely, maybe the Excelsior game after. Play Arsenal and Sparta Prague back to back. Bruges and Sparta Prague, and then we play Genk. Ooh, it's going to be an interesting start to November. December is going to be, December's so busy. Oh my Jesus. Right, so like I said, back in a second for the Valencia game. Don't go anywhere. So here we are, lads. First game of the Champions League against the team we beat last year in the Europa League, Valencia. So guaranteed that we won't meet in the final of the Europa League again. Interestingly, form has been good since we were here last. We played Standard Liège, drew nil all, disappointing game, and then against Excel Mouscron, we won 3-0. Diallo with the first, and double deckers got himself a cheeky little brace. We have made one more signing since you were here last. Deadline day, in came Jose Augusto. Did we lose anybody? We lost Wesley Van Britsum, who was in the team for a period last year. He came through the youth intake, if I'm not mistaken. I hoped he was going to come good. We'll never know now because he's left. So he's gone to Mechelen. I don't know why he'd leave. He was in the position to get into the first team, but we're never going to be able to see him play now. Jose Augusto is a player that did come in. For some reason, another left back. We needed a right back. No. Left back. He looks good. Nowhere near as good as Nathan. So Nathan is going to continue as our starting left back. But Jose Augusto, he's a handy backup, I guess. Because of the issue that we've come across, we have Gallardo learning to be a right back. Because I only want a backup right back, because we have De Gresse who can play there as well. So just teach him to be right back. It's basically the same thing as being a left back, and he's either footed. So makes the most sense to me, I guess. we had to make some omissions from our squad because we have so many non-Belgian players at the club now. So Dosso, who played in the last game and played really rather well, hasn't made it. Julian hasn't made it either, and he's pretty pissed. And Blish was unfortunate in his omission as well. Sadija is pretty pissed off. He has been since Yannick Jax left for Valencia. The director of football didn't bring in a player to replace him, and Sadija has just been bitching and moaning. So I can imagine he's probably going to want to leave by January. So I'd say we probably lose him in January as well. It's fine because Dodora and Leo have been playing quite well together recently, so I'm not overly bothered by it. Carnevale has finally come into the goals. Rodriguez hasn't scored yet, so Carnevale does start up front today. Mitkov, back from his injuries, is the first game he's available to play in. So he's going to get his opportunity to play against Valencia again. And both of the players that Valencia took off us in the last two seasons aren't playing. So Roberto doesn't get a chance to play against us again. And Jax is sitting on the bench. So we are going to assertively tell them that they have the chance to make the media happy. I hope Deckers can do what he did in the last game, because he was exceptional in that game. He took control and just dominated. And it was fantastic. I enjoyed every moment of him being on the ball. But it is a question of whether he can continue doing that. Nketa, that was a terrible attempt at a tackle. Yeah, it was Nketa. That was a shocker. That was such a bad attempt. Harvey Elliott with the corner, it gets sort of cleared, but not really. Bornet starts against his former club again. I think with the way Bornet has been playing recently, he is going to be the number one keeper. Dreisen will continue to sit on the bench, at least for every league game anyway. Because in Europe, we don't need to worry about having six players who were trained in Belgium. So, for the time being anyway, the Ryzen is going to sit on the bench until we either find until January. Or unless someone comes through that is fantastic in our youth. Somebody who rockets up and suddenly gets really, really good. Which hasn't happened for a while now. But there's always a chance. Mikov just gets absolutely done there. Thankfully, Bornet was awake to the shot. In terms of left backs, I know saying Nathan is by far and away the starter. Yeah, oh, Dodora just puts heads over. I'm giving Jose Augusto chances. I'm taking him off, bringing him off the bench every now and again, just to give him a bit of a run around. I have moved the fullbacks back to the way they were before Mikov went out injured. Because I think Mikov is the better of the attacking wingbacks. So I might tell Dekkers to calm down and not get booked again. He's not playing great again. He's a very streaky player. He's really good. And then the next game he can be terrible. Or he can be amazing. It's very rare that he does multiple games in a row where he plays really well. And Arsenal are 2 up against Sparta Prague. 3 up against Sparta Prague. Carlos Roberto wins the ball back. Leo. What's Leo going to do with it? Back to Dodora. And Valencia win it back. But we're back on the attack again. Carlos Roberto does his man. Nathan. Whips it across. Dekkers. Oh, that was so unlucky. It seems that Dekkers has picked up a smidgen of a knock. Leo whips it in. And Dodora with the header. Dodora's not that tall, is he? 6'2". Oh, did not realise he was 6'2". The more you know. We're up to second in our group, obviously, because this is the first game of the group. And we're winning. Dekkers really having a poor game. Gormigan Gonzalez, because he plays somewhat similarly. I think I might take Mikov off at some point. The strike force, not having a great game either. Both my strikers are struggling. We're going to demand more. Mikov, you're coming off. De Gresse is going to move to right back. Everett's going to come on at centre back, and we're going to take off Diallo for Rodriguez. I'm hoping Rodriguez can get himself the goal that he needs. And I don't think we're going to see Jax make an appearance in this game. Or are we? There's still 10 minutes left. What a save by the keeper. And was that De Gresse took it off the line? Oh, Jax has come on as an attacking midfielder. He did start as a winger. Oh, Harvey Elliott. Jax did start as a winger, as an attack midfielder, as you might remember. But we moved him to right wing for, I think it was the first half season we were here. And then after that, he kind of became a striker who played as a winger as well. So we never really nailed on a position for him. And we're going to draw. 1-1 draw against Valencia. It's not the worst result in the world. They had more shots on target. Same amount of clear-cut chances. We had three half chances more than they did. I'm just going to say I'm not happy. I think we should have done better than that. I'm going to tell Deckers he was terrible. Because Deckers really let us down in that game. Because he was so good in the last one. Comes out in this one and he was just very poor. I also think that bringing Gonzalez on instead of Clark wasn't the best idea. Because Gonzalez didn't really have a great game when he came off the bench. Or am I... just, you know, 6 points, but he gave away a free kick that led to a goal. We also got Serang United in the cup, so that should be a comfortable win. The next set of games we are going to play will either be Club Brugge, Sparta Prague, or Sparta Prague Genk. That gets us into November. We'll be three games into the Champions League group. We'll be a little deeper into the league season. Be almost halfway, if I'm not mistaken. Because the Anderlecht game's not too far after. So that's what we're going to do. It's going to be Club Brugge, Sparta Prague, or Sparta Prague Genk in the next episode. Because Genk and Sparta and Club Brugge are two big teams in Belgium that are having a bit of an iffy start to the season. Sparta Prague is a game I want to play. See how we get on. It'll be the second time we played them. So we'll have played half our Champions League games. We'll see how we're getting on in the cup. And we'll be a little bit deeper in the league. So if you have enjoyed, please make sure to leave a like, comment and subscribe. Who do you think I should be playing at left back? Should I be playing Nathan? Or should I be playing Jose Augusto? I personally think Nathan is a better left back. But Nathan can also fill in at centre back. Which is very, very handy. Yeah, thank you very much for watching, fellas. Leave a like, comment, subscribe, share with all of your friends. Make sure you're 6 foot apart when you're doing it. Or do it online because of the whole pandemic that we have at the minute. Thank you very much for watching, fellas. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye!